Dear students, in the last lecture, we have seen about the endocytosis that includes the phagocytosis as well as the pinocytosis. Today class, we are going to see about the receptor mediated endocytosis process. Some kind of endocytosis in which some specific receptor are involved there in the process. So you can able to see in the right hand side animation the receptor that are of present in a Y-shaped thing. Okay. That Y-shaped things are actually the receptors in which a molecule is getting attached and it has been endocytized. It involves uptake of specific molecule that is possessing a special tag or ligand. So, some special molecule that is possessing a tag or a ligand can be attached to the matching receptor there in the cell membrane. This membrane receptor possesses an uniquely shaped projections or cavity. You can able to see a cavity like the here, which is in turn lined with some kind of a protein. Say for example, here in this particular cavity, you can able to see a violet colored coat. Clathrin is a type of protein that is present there in the pit region. So it is called as a coated pit region that fits the shape of only one molecule. Say for example, LDL. LDL refers to low density lipoprotein. It's a kind of a lipoprotein that is involved there in the cholesterol transport. This cholesterol is transported inside with the help of a LDL molecule. Materials are further processed by lysosome. Once it has been transported inside, it will be processed there by the lysosome. The receptors will be again recycled back there to the surface of the membrane. This insert is related with what is the level of cholesterol need to be maintained there in the body. Usually, the lipid cholesterol cannot dissolve directly in the blood or in the extracellular fluid as they are water-based. This fluid is a water-based, so the cholesterol, a lipid-based thing, cannot able to easily dissolve. Thus, cholesterol cannot able to cross the cell membrane by a simple pinocytosis, what we have seen in the previous lecture. So, it need to be transported by some special process such as a receptor mediated endocytosis process. For the process of the receptor mediated endocytosis, the following things are commonly required. First one, cholesterol molecules in a monolayer phospholipid cage should be present. Then a protein tag or a ligand that is present in the phospholipid cage. Then a receptor protein, which is involved in the process. That is the reason it is called as a receptor mediated endocytosis. This receptor should be embedded there in the cell membrane. So this is a receptor that have been embedded there in the cell membrane. You can be able to see a Y-shaped structure. They are all the receptors. Then clathrin coated pit. This is the one which is interacting with the receptor and it is present in the inner side of the cell membrane. So you can able to see a clathrin coated pit. That small violet dots are clathrin coated pits that have been present there in, as a inner lining there in the cell membrane. This diagram clearly explains about the entire receptor mediated endocytosis process by which cholesterol is taken up by the cells. So this is the cholesterol molecule. Yellow color thing that has been surrounded by a cage like layer. This cage like thing is made up of a single layer of phospholipids, that is a mono phospholipid layer in which cholesterol molecule has been locked. This cholesterol molecule found to have a dark blue color tag. This is called as a protein tag or ligand molecule. This protein tag or ligand molecule is made up of apolipoprotein. So this particular tab will be exactly fitting there into a receptor. That receptor is referred as a matching receptor. As this kind of receptors are involved there in this process, it has been referred as a receptor mediated endocytosis process. You look at the first step. The cholesterol that have been produced there in the liver are enclosed in a water-soluble cage-like thing with a protein tag on it. The dark blue is the protein tag and the light blue is the matching receptor. You look at the first step that has been given under the heading of A. Cholesterol molecules are produced in the liver and they need to be taken up to the different cells, as the cholesterol molecules are need to be embedded there in the cell membrane. So they are enclosed there in a water soluble cage. That cage is the one which is made up of a single monolayer of phospholipid with a protein tag in it. This particular protein tag containing cholesterol molecules will be attached there to a matching receptor in a particular region that is called as a coated pit region. It is looking like a pit and it is having some kind of a coating. So it is called as a coated pit region. This coating is in turn made up of a protein called as a clathrin, that is clathrin coat. This clathrin protein is a fibrous protein, triskelion units, assembled as a polygonal lattice and forms into a coat on the cytoplasmic side of the plasma membrane. And it will be interacting there with the receptor protein. This receptor protein will be interacting there with the protein tag. So with this sort of interactions, the cholesterol molecule will be getting easily bound there to the receptor. The tag bonds to its matching receptor on a cell that needs cholesterol. At this point, the receptor mediated endocytosis process will be taking place. So you look at the C point, endocytosis has been completed. Whatever that have been coming inside, that is cholesterol molecule, are all taken inside the endocytosis vesicle. Due to the differences in the pH inside the cell, the vesicle that containing the cholesterol molecule will be pinches into two. One holds completely the empty receptor, whereas in the other it is full of cholesterol molecules. So the empty receptors will be further recycled there to the membrane. Again they will go and attach to the surface of the membrane. This receptor will again help in taking up the protein tag containing cholesterol molecule inside. What happens to the cholesterol containing endocytosis cage? It will be degraded by the enzymes that have been present inside the cell. As a result, the cholesterol molecule will be released there on the interior part of the cell. This cholesterol molecule will go and bind to the membrane and they help in maintaining the proper fluidity of the cell membranes. So the whole process is referred as a receptor mediated endocytosis process, which commonly happens in any kind of a cell, mainly to take up the cholesterol molecule that is required for. Now we come to the last part of this lecture, the exocytosis. So this one is the opposite to that of the endocytosis. In the right hand side you can able to see a GIF image demonstrating the process of exocytosis. So it is a process of exuding the secretory products to outside the cell cytoplasm. It is also referred by another term called as a hemiocytosis. A vesicle from inside the cell move to the cell surface. You look at there in the right hand side, the same thing is happened. There the vesicular membrane fuses with cell membrane, thus restoring the membrane which was previously removed by the process of endocytosis. The content of the outward bound vesicle are secreted into the outside environment or into the extracellular environment. The exocytosis is an important in specialized cell of human pancreas. The reason is pancreas are involved in the secretion of human hormone insulin. So the insulin is the one which is very important to regulate the glucose level in the body. That insulin will be secreted from the pancreas by a simple process of this exocytosis. Other human digestive enzymes, neurotransmitters, are also secreted through the process of exocytosis. Among protists, that is protozoa, contractile vacuoles contents are all will be discharged into the outside environment with the help of exocytosis process.